In this video, we will be talking about stationary points of a curve. So, the first question is, what are stationary points? Well, stationary points are the points where the gradient of the tangent to the curve at those points are zero. In other words, if the curve is given by y equals fx, where fx is a function such as x squared plus 2x minus 1, then the stationary points are the point where the derivative of y with respect to x are zero, which we can write it as dy over dx equals zero. In this example, we will be finding the coordinates of the stationary points of the curve y equals 4x squared minus 3x plus 1. So first, we need to find the derivative of y with respect to x, or dy over dx. Dy over dx is equals to the derivative of 4x squared, which is 4, times by the derivative of x squared, which is 2x, plus the derivative of negative 3x, which is negative 3, and plus the derivative of 1, which is 0. So therefore, dy over dx is equals to 8x minus 3. And at stationary points, dy over dx is equal to 0. So therefore, at stationary points, dy over dx equals 0, which means 8x minus 3 is equals to 0. We can solve for x by adding 3 to both sides, which will give 8x equals 3. Then we divide 8 from both sides, which will give x equals 3 over 8. So we have our x coordinate of our stationary point. However, we also need to find the y coordinate of this stationary point. Since all stationary points lies on the curve, we can find the y coordinate by substituting in x equals 3 over 8 into y equals 4x squared minus 3x plus 1. So therefore, y is equals to 4 multiplied by 3 over 8 squared minus 3 times by 3 over 8 and plus 1. This value is 7 over 16. This means that the stationary point of the curve y equals 4x squared minus 3x plus 1 is 3 over 8 and 7 over 16. In this second example, we will be finding the coordinates of the stationary points of the curve y equals x cubed minus 6x squared minus 15x plus 4. So, same with the first example, we will have to find the derivative of y with respect to x, or dy over dx. And this is equals to the derivative of x cubed, which is 3x squared, the derivative of negative 6x squared, which is negative 6, times by the derivative of x squared, which is 2x, plus the derivative of negative 15x, which is negative 15, and plus the derivative of 4, which is 0. So therefore, dy over dx is equals to 3x squared minus 12x minus 15. And at stationary points, the derivative of y with respect to x, or dy over dx, is equals to 0. So therefore, 3x squared minus 12x minus 15 is equals to 0. So we have a quadratic, which we can actually factorize and solve. So first, we can factorize out the 3 from every single term. So our new expression on the left hand side is 3 multiplied by in brackets x squared minus 4x minus 5 equals to 0. So this means that x squared minus 4x minus 5 is equals to 0, which we can write it out as x squared minus 4x minus 5 equals to 0. And we can also factorize this quadratic into two different brackets, which gives us x minus 5 multiplied by x plus 1 is equal to 0. So therefore, the x coordinates of our stationary points are x equals 5 and x equals negative 1. So in this example, we have two stationary points, but we now have to find the y coordinates of these stationary points. And similarly, as all stationary points lie on the curve, we can find the y coordinate by substituting in x equals 5 and x equals negative 1 into y equals x cubed minus 6x squared minus 15x plus 4. So at x equals 5, y equals to 5 cubed minus 6 times by 5 squared minus 15 multiplied by 5 and plus 4. This value is equals to 54. And at x equals negative 1, y is equals to negative 1 cubed minus 6 times by negative 1 squared minus 15 multiplied by negative 1 plus 4. And this value is equals to negative 18. So therefore, the stationary points of our curve, y equals x cubed minus 6x squared minus 15x plus 4, are 5, 54, and negative 1, negative 18.